Tuesday Night Baseball set to come your way from Fenway Park in Boston. A good matchup here for you tonight between the Baltimore Orioles and the Boston Red Sox. It'll be fun watching these two swing it all series long. First pitch is next. Clay Buchholz, a right-hander from the state of Texas, is the man on the mound here. What do we need to know here, EK?
Well, remember, he will show that cutter just to keep the hitter off balance, basically to keep the hitter honest. Doesn't want him sitting on certain pitches.
At the plate, Nolan Reimold, as he'll get his first opportunity in this one. Buchholz gets the sign. 1-1 pitch on its way. And a changeup runs inside on him as he's got to back out of the way of that one. Eric Karros, this Red Sox ball club entering play here tonight. They come in looking to turn things around as they've dropped two straight.
And I think it's just going to be a matter of putting yesterday behind you. It wasn't their finest performance of the year, that's for sure, but they're capable of playing much better ball, and I think we'll see a sharper focus here in this one.
All even at 2-2. Here it is. Did a good job to shorten up and protect the plate, and he'll have another shot at it here. Into the windup, here comes the 2-2 pitch. Full count, 3-2.
You don't want to lose the leadoff hitter here. Not when you've got this guy on deck.
Good battle, count remains full. Locked in a good battle. Here comes another one. Toward left center and fairly deep. Back goes Betts. And just short of a home run, this ball's off the wall. And this will wind up a closer play than I thought, but he's in there with two bases.
And I'll tell you what, anytime you come into this building as a visiting player, you think to yourself, I've got to find a way to take advantage of that monster out there in left. And here he sends one out there to kick off the ball game, and he makes his way into second with an easy leadoff two-bagger.
Standing in now, Manny Machado.
That's ball two.
To two balls and two strikes now. Where do you go from here?
I think he's set up for something off speed. If you can put that changeup below his knees, he won't come within a foot of it.
Boy, good cutting action to that pitch as that's the first out of the inning.
Batting third.
Well, this pitch looked to be up. We'll get a look at it on the pitch track. And, yep, you'll see it there. Well, that thing's well above the letters. You're just playing right into the pitcher's hand when you chase a ball that high.
Stepping in now, Chris Davis. And that misses as Davis will reach. It's ball four.
Tough take there on 3-1. I mean, if this pitch missed the inside corner, it did not miss by much. But he's going to reach base anyway.
Adam Jones steps up to the plate with a great chance to drive in a run here in the early going.
And you know, you hear it all the time, but scoring first really is a big deal in this game. Statistically, your chance of winning the game goes up quite a bit when you score first, so this is a big opportunity right now.
Runners are at first and second with one away. Strike three called, and now he's one out away from getting out of this.
Well, you talk about a big time to come up with a strikeout. Now, you still got one more guy to get through here in the inning, but now with two outs, you can take a step back, take a deep breath, and know that those runners have to stay put at first and second.
Matt Wieters will stand in, and he is off to a dreadful start at the plate as he has not hit the ball well in April. Two and one.
A two-out hit here would be nice, but a two-out walk wouldn't be the worst thing in the world either.
Two Now he lifts a high pop-up, drifting into foul territory on the right side. And the two-out threat will not come to pass as the inning is over. Orioles strand a couple, O's zero. Sox coming to the plate. You're watching Major League Baseball on the show. Ubaldo Jimenez is ready to go as he'll be on the hill for Baltimore. What's your take on him, EK?
Remember, guys, this is someone that will come at you with four different pitches. He'll change velocity, he'll go up and down. The break on the pitches makes it a real challenge for a hitter.
Mookie Betts will dig in now. Off to a slow start, as you see there, just barely over the 200 mark here in April. Ready to deal, here's the 1-1. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike. EK, you look at these Orioles as they begin play here tonight. They come in as hot as anyone in this first week of the season, as they've won five of their first six contests.
And they've been as hot as anybody in the league recently. So all they need to do is keep playing the way they've been playing. And you have to say, they stack up with anybody in baseball.
Had him fooled there as this is lifted in the air out to left center and shallow. Reimold comes on and makes the catch in shallow left for out number one.
And sometimes when you're just getting rolling here in a ball game, you've got a three ball count. Hey, go ahead and lay one in there. Make him prove to you that he can beat you. This winds up a pretty routine fly ball.
Dustin Pedroia will dig in now. And as you can see, he's well over 300 here to start this new campaign. Ready with the 1-1 pitch. Hit high in the air down the right field line. And that'll get down for a base hit.
Batting third, the shortstop.
Xander Bogaerts takes his first shot here with the runner at first now and one away. There goes Pedroia. Pitch swung out and missed the throw. Short hop, and he's there just before the tag.
Just your classic single and a stolen base. Now with one out in the first, another base hit here to put that first run on the board.
Try to come in with the fastball, but it's too far in, and it's even at 2-2. He took second fairly easily. Any thought of third base here?
I don't think so. You've got a good hitter at the plate. A single is probably all he needs. I'd let him try to drive you in.
Here's the pitch on 2-2. Hit hard on the ground to second. Scope has it. And boy, just about overshot his man at first, but he's able to keep a foot on the bag over there, and that's out number two.
Boy, as a hitter, you know you're hoping to get that ball into the outfield somewhere, make it hit the grass, give your guy a chance to score. In this situation, all he does is get to third base. That's not a big help.
David Ortiz will stand in, and you see the average there, up over 300 to start the new season. Grounded to short. Party's there. And this sails right over Davis's head. Low throw, and he can't handle the short hop.
Well, you know his glove work out there at shortstop is top notch, but his accuracy with his arm can sometimes let him down every once in a while. He winds up just throwing this one away.
Into the box now, Hanley Ramirez. A good action on the two-seamer there, and it's 1-2. And set up behind the plate is Kenny Jansen, as you see the rest of the umpiring crew there.
Jansen's known for being a bit of a pitcher's umpire. Not that he has a huge zone or anything, but I think he tends to reward guys for placing pitches in good locations.
Looking for the strikeout, here's the 1-2. Got him swinging, and that will end the inning. So it's one run, one hit, one error in the inning, and a runner left. On to the second inning now from Fenway Park. It's the Red Sox 1 and the Orioles nothing. Mark Trumbo will stand in, and as you can see the big number there, he's up over 400 to begin the campaign. This is lined to left, and a base hit here to open up the second. So with the leadoff man aboard, we take a trip into the recent past here as we call on our graphic for today's edition of This Date in Baseball History. In now, Jonathan Scope. He'll get to take his first cuts here. Nobody out, runner on first. Line to the right side. But this is right at him in right field as he hardly has to move to take it in for the first out.
And this could have really got this inning off to a great start, but it finds the outfielder's glove out there, and that runner's forced to retreat back to first.
Into the box, J.J. Hardy swinging a high pop-up back onto the outfield grass now. Under it is Sandoval, and there's the second out.
Batting ninth, the right fielder, number three, Ryan Flaherty.
Ryan Flaherty set to take his first cuts with a man at first and two away. Red Sox on top in the early going, 1-0 as we play the second. And he'll fall behind now to 1-2. And another foul ball. And that's high for a ball. It's 2-2.
Ooh, there's a tough one to take right there on a 1-2 pitch, especially after fighting off so many pitches leading up to that one.
Buchholz sets. Here he comes on 2-2. Swing and a miss. Blew the fastball right by him, and the inning is over. Orioles leave one. They trail this one 1-0. Pablo Sandoval strides into the box now to lead off the home half of the second inning. Here he comes on a ball and two strikes. Hard hit ball to second, and it's through for a base hit. They'll have the leadoff man aboard to start the inning.
A good job there of making a two-strike adjustment.
Right fielder,
very compact Bruce there. He uses the middle of the field, and this just finds its way into center for a base hit.
Ruzne Castillo steps in now. A runner at first with no outs here. And it's full now, 3-2.
Well, this is turning into a real dogfight now.
Bat explodes as this has popped up.
That ball was so deep in his kitchen, that was the only thing he could do was foul it off, break his bat, and hope to get a better pitch on the next one.
He's set. Here's the 3-2. And here's a slider. Strike three called, and that'll be the first out of the inning.
And this is where the scouting report really pays off. I mean, sometimes you just got to go looking for a soft spot in the guy's zone, and they found one there.
In now, Blake Swihart. And he takes ball two, and it's 2-1.
Well, if he's missing right here, he ain't missing by much. Not getting too many favors behind the plate.
There's the cold strike he was looking for. 2-2 now.
Right back inside with a fastball. This time, he got the call.
Swing and a hot shot towards the hole. Solid base hit for him, his first of the afternoon.
Well, that's one thing about having a switch hitting catcher in the lineup. This guy causes so many matchup problems. Comes through with a solid single here.
Jackie Bradley Jr. stands in. Took him right up the ladder that time, and it's 1-2.
Wow, no chance of getting on top of that fastball. I mean, that's helmet level right there.
Ground ball to second. This could be two. Hardy for one. On to Davis at first. It's a double play, and the side is retired. 4-6-3. They roll it up to get out of the jam. Back with more here on a Tuesday night after this. Nolan Reimold will be the first to stand in here in the inning for Baltimore with Manny Machado waiting to follow.
And guys, this is the guy you want leading off this inning. He's your leadoff man, so maybe he can get things started, set the table for a little bit of a rally.
Drilled to first. Ramirez gloves it, and he'll take this to the bag of three unassisted for the first out.
The third baseman, number 13, Manny Machado.
Manny Machado is into the box. He was a strikeout victim in his first try.
It was a pretty big strikeout too, because he had a chance to drive in a run, so I'm sure he's going to be thinking about that missed opportunity for a little while.
And this misses, so that'll fill the count at 3-2. You have to figure that he's really going to need to keep the walks in check if he's going to have success here.
I was thinking the same thing. No free rides. You got to make these guys earn it.
Got him looking with the fastball, as that had some two-seam movement to it. Two gone.
And he's having a rough go of it so far. His second strikeout of the ballgame. You can see him gesturing that he thinks that pitch was outside. But, you know, I think once he gets a look at it in the clubhouse, he'll probably change his tune.
Now to the plate, Chris Davis. He drew a walk his first time up. Bases are empty here with two men out. And this misses for ball four. The second walk he surrendered here in the first three innings.
Yeah, that's pretty clearly a pitch around. They didn't want any part of him.
With the bases empty and two outs, a walk's not the worst thing in the world.
So it's a runner at first with two gone, and standing in the fine center fielder, Adam Jones. On its way, the 0-2 pitch. Inside, as that perhaps will back him off a bit. 1-2.
I think he had him flinching on that one. That nearly came back to the inside corner.
One and two, here it comes. A little late on the fastball, but he's able to spoil that one off, and he'll get another chance. Late making contact on that swing, and will do it again on 1-2. Just inside, not by much. It's 2-2. You like what you've seen from this guy so far?
I do. I like where he's putting the fastball, and I like the movement he's been getting on both his curveball and changeup. I think he'll do well.
2-2 count. Here it comes. Swing and a miss, and that ends the inning. One left for the Orioles. It remains 1-0. Mookie Betts digs into the box in the bottom of inning number 3.
And you know, guys, I love a guy like this leading off an inning for you. He makes good contact and he can run.
And he'll try to get him fishing there, but he won't offer in the dirt, and it's back to even at 2-2. And this misses from Jimenez, and that'll fill up the count now, 3-2.
Yeah, and that's not the pitch you want to throw on 2-2. I mean, that was so high, he didn't even have to think about swinging at it.
Grounded to third. Machado has it. And he's retired here, one away.
The second baseman, number 15, Justin Pedroia.
One away, and here's the 2008 AL MVP, Dustin Pedroia. And that is in there at the letters to run it full, 3-2. Chop foul over towards the coaching box. Swing and a miss as he ran that two-seamer right by him for the second out.
Well, just a two-seam fastball. You'll see the movement here. It works back toward the inside corner, and he picks up strikeout number 3 so far.
Stepping in now, Xander Bogaerts. Inside as he nearly got him, and it's ball 4.
Yeah, they went to the slider there on 3-2, and that's a pitch where you're really hoping a hitter will see fastball and swing through it. But it didn't work out that time. He winds up losing him.
David Ortiz will dig in now, hoping to perhaps make him pay for the two-out walk.
Yeah, nothing going on earlier in this inning, but a chance to make some noise right here. Those kind of walks often seem to come back and bite guys somehow.
This is hit high and deep out to left. Raimold ranging back, but he can't get to this one. It's off the wall. So now they'll have runners on the corners with two away.
And maybe this is one of the few drawbacks as a hitter of having that 37-foot wall out there in left. Any other park in the big leagues, this is a double. Here, it's fielded quickly out left, and they hold him to just a loud single.
Into the box now, Hanley Ramirez. And a check swing here as he couldn't help himself, and it's ruled strike 2. Chop foul at the plate. It'll remain 1-2. very weakly on the ground, but that one rolls foul. Trying to strike him out for the second time. And a slider runs away from him there, and the count levels at 2-2.
He showed him that slider running away two times in a row. Now might be a good time to call in that two-seamer running in.
Good battle here. This will be the seventh pitch coming up. Hit in the air to right field. Flaherty has it in his tracks, and that retires the side. Some of our nation's young minds and future leaders here in attendance. Yikes. Don't go anywhere. More Tuesday Night Baseball after this. Leading off the inning, Matt Wieters, as they'll look to get something going here and even this game up.
And right here is an important time for them to climb back into this one. They definitely want to even this one up sooner rather than later.
Buchholz is ready. 1-1 on its way. Can't keep the weight back, and he falls behind 1-2. And a good take there. Close, but it's 2-2. Still 2-2. And they really bunch him up on that one as he swings and misses for the first out. So with that, let's call on the guys in the graphics department to put up the pitch speed comparison for the two starters. And both of these guys working in pretty much the same realm, just a 1 mile an hour differential from 94 down to 93 is the top speeds. So one gone in the inning, and that'll bring up the always dangerous Mark Trumbo. Two balls and a strike. Here it is. And he gives this one a pretty good ride down the left field line. But this will land foul just shy of the wall. No runs, two hits, one error thus far for Baltimore. Swing and a miss on the changeup, and there are two gone.
Well, right now he is just carving them up, dare I say, like a Thanksgiving turkey. That's seven strikeouts already, and he's made it look easy so far.
Jonathan Schoop stands in looking to put the bat on the ball for a change here with the first two guys going down on strikes to start the inning. Nope. Down low, two balls and a strike. That's going to even up the count at 2-2. Smoked on the ground left side. And that's through for a hit.
And after going strikeout, strikeout to start the inning, looked like he was on his way to an easy 1-2-3. After the base hit there, he's going to have to work now with a two-out base runner.
J.J. Hardy is into the box for his second appearance. 0-for-1 with a flyout. A runner on first with two away. Skied into straightaway right. And he'll get there in plenty of time to put this one away, and that ends the inning. Orioles leave one. They still trail 1-0. Pablo Sandoval is set to lead us off in the home half of the fourth inning. One and two now as that one's fouled off. A ball and two strikes. Here's the pitch. Able to protect the plate with two strikes, and he'll see another one. Belted high in the air out to left. Leimold ranging back, but he has no chance to make the play. It's off the wall. The throw into second, and he's able to hustle his way up to second as he'll reach here with a two-base hit.
Well, you knew he was going to be halfway to the cycle one way or the other. And I don't think he got quite all of that one, but he still gave it a pretty good ride. He's going to pull into second with his second base hit, and this one's a double.
Standing in now, Ruzne Castillo. The 1-2 offering looked like a slider that time, but it's 2-2. Sent out to straightaway center field. Jones is right there, one down. But he gets back in time, safe at second base.
Now batting, number 23.
Now at the plate, Blake Swihart. He singled his last time up.
And they take another single right here, too, no doubt. Runner in scoring position, so any ball into the outfield probably gets him home.
High and wide, two balls and a strike. Two-one pitch is a fastball swung on and missed 2-2. A pretty dangerous spot for that one.
I don't think it was by design. It's one thing to miss your spots out of the zone, but when you miss in the zone, especially up, that's when you tend to get hurt.
Line drive to left. And this is going to be a fair ball as it'll head to the corner. Here comes the Panda. And a relay to the plate. And they're not going to get him. He's in there at the plate.
The left fielder, number 25.
Jackie Bradley Jr. steps in with one in, one out, and one on here in the inning.
Yeah, it's been a pretty good inning here so far, so we'll see if they can scratch another run across right here.
Swing and a miss on the splitter, and it's 1-2. Ready to deliver the 1-2. That misses, and we're even at 2-2. Chop foul at the plate, and the count holds at 2-2. Runner at first here, one man out. Goes the other way with it as this is in the air down the line and left. Under it is Reimold now, and that's out number two.
Well, the only good news that comes out of this at-bat is that he stayed out of the double play. Other than that, this at-bat really didn't achieve a whole lot.
Mookie Betts will try it again. 0-for-2 with a fly out and a ground ball thus far.
Well, guys, if you split the difference between the fly ball and the grounder he's put in play, you've got a nice line drive. So maybe we'll witness that right here.
That nibbled the corner there, but missed 2-1. This one's blooped out toward right center field. Coming in is Jones. And that's the third out. So they pick up a run on two hits, no errors, and a man left. We played four full. It's the Red Sox 2 and the Orioles nothing. Leading off the inning, Ryan Flaherty. And they'll need him to get something going here.
And in a pretty close game so far, they'd love to see this guy get on base so they can get a rally started to get back in this thing. Oh.
Fastball close, but he didn't get it. 2-1. Hey. 2-2. Well, that pitch isn't going to light up the radar gun, but it's been effective.
Well, it doesn't have to. If you get that good movement and put it in the right spot, it's plenty good enough to do the job.
Buchholz into the windup. 2-2 on its way home. Hits this one hard the other way. Pedroia fields it cleanly. And a bit of a high throw that time, but no problem over there at first as they record the out.
Outfielder number 14, Nolan Reimold.
Nolan Reimold strides in, grounded out his last time through. All even now, 2-2. Again, he sends it out of play. And he struck him out. Good pitch there as he registers his 8th punch out of the ball game.
Yeah, you know, sometimes as a hitter, when you get into that cycle of fouling off pitch after pitch and trying to protect, you just feel like you have to swing at everything you see. And here, he knows that out on the mound, so he just keeps going farther and farther away from the strike zone until he finally gets a swing and miss.
Manny Machado will stand in now. A punch out victim twice already. EK, I'll ask you, because you're the one sitting next to me, do you approach an at bat differently when you have 2 strikeouts under your belt this early in the game?
Well, you do, in the sense that whatever you did the first 2 times, it wasn't working. But I think if you start worrying too much about trying to avoid the hat trick, or worse, it'll start becoming a mind game and you'll start falling into some pretty bad habits.
No runs, 3 hits, 1 error thus far for Baltimore. Out in front as this is drilled into left field. That's a base hit.
Yeah, he got a little revenge there. He struck out twice before that, and now he gets him back with a solid base hit.
Chris Davis will get a shot here with 2 away and a runner at first now following the base hit.
That 2-out single seemed harmless enough, but anytime you extend the inning to allow this guy to get a shot with a runner on, you better be careful.
Foul right at the plate. The count moves now to 1-2. Fought off at the plate, and we'll do it again. Ah, and he strikes him out to end it here, as they were able to get the possible tying run to the plate, but could not cash in.
Yeah, you know, this game kind of felt like it could have been played back in 1968. Very well played, very low scoring, very quick game, too. I'll tell you, I could go for a few more of these this year. That'd be okay by me.
For one final check of the line score, as you see the key players there in this shutout victory. So the Red Sox helped out quite a bit by the start turned in by this man, Clay Buchholz. Strike a pose. He's our top player of the game.
Yeah, definitely no debate as far as I'm concerned. He was really in complete control the whole way through. Only really got into trouble a few times, and he winds up with a complete game shutout.
So that's a wrap here tonight. For my partners in the booth, Eric Karros and Steve Lyons, and our entire crew, I'm Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. And for more, click on over to theshownation.com. The Red Sox win it 2-0. Good night from Fenway.